Let's just see if this is gonna fit.
In the St. Thomas Manufacturing Lab, mechanical engineering major Brynn Kasper pursues a degree while pushing personal buttons. Engineering is one of her hobbies.
You tell the computer what to do and it does it for you.
Combine this passion with her other hobby, and Kasper can open the world of engineering exploration to others. During the school year,
we'll do chemical next week. We are doing mechanical this week.
Kasper and her team of St. Thomas students explore engineering with middle schoolers, where sounds give way to American Sign Language, Kasper's other hobby,
yeah.
At St. Paul's Metro Deaf School.
But now we're gonna make it real life, and they actually have to use the Earth's laws of gravity and physics to figure out what a mechanical engineer does.
Real life for Kasper is two grandparents who are deaf.
They would sit and read me little children's books in sign language, and so it's been a part of my life, my whole life.
Kasper shares herself this day through an engineering lesson, students designing and building forts for a contest based on the video game Angry Birds. Each group will learn whether its design protects pigs from birds. This engineering classroom began when Kasper applied to join St. Thomas's Playful Learning Lab.
We always say you learn more when you're laughing about it.
Dr. AnnMarie Thomas says beyond the fun, there's a serious pursuit of science, technology, engineering, and math, known as STEM.
STEM outreach, particularly to deaf children, is less discussed, and it's a fairly unique program.
I just noticed that if we move things around, it can block it.
Given a chance to redesign, fifth grader Carter Swinney seizes the learning opportunity.
Yeah, I enjoy engineering.
And participating, learning, is more fun for Jonathan Buchanan than talking about it.
I want to go, yeah. I want to know what's happening. And you guys are going to launch them at the same time.
Ultimately, Kasper aims to broaden minds, improve critical thinking, and increase real-world application. Metro Deaf School sees the impact.
And here it's more special. It's more motivating because it's a fun learning environment.
This lesson ends with cleanup and reflection.
Carter here said it was his favorite one so far. Your favorite this week? Angry Birds, yeah. So I think it went really well. We put a lot into planning the building the structures and getting these boxes and building the catapults and slingshots.
It all goes back to Kasper's hobbies and St. Thomas's willingness to reach out.
I really don't think it would have been possible anywhere at any other university. It is really unique.